good, YouTube? It's your boy Dev back again for another first listen. What's good, Twitch? It's your boy Dev back again for another live first listen. Y'all know who it is right there, man. Everybody say what's up, YouTube. Y'all got a chat right there. Y'all guys can say what's up. Hey, y'all, I'm on TV. Yeah, we on YouTube. Mom, look, I'm on YouTube. I'm on Dev channel. Yeah, me, I'm here. Yeah, I'm right there. Look at that comment right there. Yeah, me. Today we got DJ Khaled releasing a surprise album, actually. A 14-track album. Already two tracks, Grease and obviously Pop Star that we've heard. So that's why I called it a 12-track initially. The album is called Khaled. Can't tell you that it is very creative, but you know, I like how he has two kids. I guess that you could say Khaled, DJ Khaled. Oh, that kind of makes sense if you want to put it into that. I want to give him that much credit, though. I don't think he's that creative where he's going to think of a concept like that. But you got DJ Khaled in the middle. Then you got his son, Khaled, and then his daughter, kids. You got his kid on the left, Khaled. Kid on the right, Khaled. And so I think that's kind of cool. I guess a cool concept if I just made it up for him. A lot of feature artists on here. A lot of power hitters. A lot of big names. We got Lil Wayne, Jeremiah, Lil Baby on a couple tracks. Cardi B, H.E.R., Migos, Post Malone, Meg Thee Stallion, DaBaby, two Bryson Tillers, more 21 Savage, Justin Bieber. So I don't know how you could possibly fuck this up. Like, I really don't know how you could fuck this up. But, you know, it's DJ Khaled. His last album wasn't that great. I still do love a couple tracks. I feel like for me, man, every time I listen to a DJ Khaled album, ever since, you know, he was putting Miami on back in the 08s, 09s, 07s, we the best! You know, he was we the best, nigga! You know, he was doing that shit back in the day. He can't really say it now because we are in a sensitive-ass era. But when he was doing that shit back in the day, he was making some fire-ass music, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, This My City, all that shit. Like, he was repping the 305 hard, so I'm always going to be appreciative of DJ Khaled for doing that. But we're going to get it's a little nice, little quick listen, which I'm happy about. You guys know I love my less than 14-track albums because I feel like you get the quality instead of the quantity. So hopefully I'm not let down. Brent. All right, we got to send this nigga. He said Brent overrated. Hold on. Let me send this nigga to the gulag real quick so he can have a pistol round to go. All right. Hopefully you win that bitch and you come back, bro. All right. Have fun in the gulag, nigga. All right, we got track one, Thankful, featuring Lil Wayne Jeremiah. Ooh, ooh, okay. I dig the sample.
We the best music.
There he go. Get his one line out of the way.
Another one.
Second line out the way.
I'm thankful. I done lost a few heartbreaks. Never lost a thing I can't replace it.
It's been a while since we heard from Amaterasu Jeremiah. Now, if y'all know why I call him Amaterasu Jeremiah, go listen to those Late Nights Europe. You know, go listen to the Late Night tapes. Like, that motherfucker Jeremiah was on a killing spree for a little bit. And there's a reason why. Even that motherfucking collab tape he did with Ty Dolla, that shit went in. A lot of very underrated project. A lot of people slept on that shit. Jeremiah been doing a damn thing. So this is my problem too. I love how he has a Jay-Z sample in there. But my thing is, I'm tired of the gospel shit. All right, if I want to listen to gospel shit, I would literally listen to some gospel shit. I think that it's really hard to kind of master that sound, really. And I just, you know, when you hear tracks like that, man, like it's just like I'm gonna throw your ass in the gulag. Like that's literally what I'm gonna do. Like the same way I did Holy. It's the same way I'm going to do this track, too. Like, it's... And I know Lil Wayne is not going to save it. This ain't 2008. This ain't 2007. I'm trying to think that this might be the track that Kanye was listening to, and then that's what he gave him the thumbs up. Because, you know, Kanye has been involving himself with the Jesus shit. Look, Kanye has been an artist that who was involved himself with a lot of gospel samples and whatnot. But his last album for me still is not it. There's some tracks that I like, but it's the first miss of his discography for me. I'm not saying it's a bad album. It won a Grammy, and you know the gospel people loved it. But I'm just saying, like, for me, I just think that even with Kanye's geniusness in music, it just didn't save it. You know what I feel?
Though it's painful, I look up and see clouds, meet angels, see white chalk. I done turned that to the blanket. I've been out of hand, so I don't want no dab unless you bang it. I'm being quiet, man, just waiting for these rappers to thank me.
All right, I'm going to tell you right now, that song was entirely too long. I think the gospel kind of sound is getting a little overplayed now. A lot of artists are using it to their advantage. They know that Kanye did it. Look, again, there go Kanye having an influence. You know, everybody now is, you know, doing that shit, making it crazy. I think that, man, Lil Wayne definitely ate his verse. I did, was, kind of counted him out, you know, preemptively. And I think that, you know, he ate his verse. He did his damn thing. A little bit of long two run time on the beat, just letting it drag out a little too long. But to be fair, it is the longest track on the album, and everything else kind of gets into a regular length. So that being said, you know, let's just get to the next track. Track two, Every Chance I Get, featuring Lil Baby and Lilder. I feel like this is gonna be one of them car bangers. Like, you gotta play this in the car to get the full of
keep going.
Yeah. What was that? I mean, just because you don't make a beat though, man, doesn't necessarily say you can't say that it was mixed bad. I mean, I wouldn't say I'm not saying the technicality of it. I just say it sounds bad. I mean, I'm not a genius. I just know that if it smells like shit and it looks like shit, then 9 times out of 10, it's shit. You know, like. It's a CeeLo, I need cash, don't sell me shit. Baby got his hood, I'm smashing. You can tell they really rich. Drop the low, ain't no room right now. I feel like this is more like, more so like a hype drill type beat though. Like, let me know if I'm wrong about that. It's a scam, I sit on my lap cause I'm pulling her tracks and I fall from the back cause she calling me handsome. And that nigga Dirk ate that shit. He had to ask me who was better on that verse. I think Dirk was better than Baby. I can't get over that little Baby moan. No EDP. Pause. I cannot get over that little Baby moan though. Like, if you had to ask me for that track, man, it was definitely a drill beat. So it's understandable that little Dirk would eat it more than little Baby. I think Lil Baby was doing his thing until he did the moan. I think that, you know, it does sound a little bit weird. There was nothing exciting about the beat either. It was just a straight-through beat. I think that, man, a lot of people fail to realize, man, production is not just having one beat go all the way through for 4 minutes or 3 minutes long and, you know, and just letting it ride. Like, nah. Like, and that was more so like a freestyle, I would say, if you ask me. I would say that's more a freestyle. There was nothing creative about the beat, but, again, it's DJ Khaled, so... why would you think it'd be creative? Tay Keith was on there as well. I expect a little bit better from Tay Keith, you know, for him to be a veteran in this game now, man, you know, to give us a little bit, at least a bit more pop and sound or something that's going to kind of just, you know, hit. I know that track sounds really good right now. I'll probably play it in the car a couple times, and then it's forgettable. I feel like that's what's going to happen. It's forgettable. You got a My Anime list? I do not have a My Anime list. My friends do. I don't do that, though. I have not got one. Skip next track is Cardi. I'm not skipping the next track. I don't know what y'all got against these women. All right, women can make good music as well. I don't know what y'all got against that. So, yeah, we go. But the next track is called Big Paper featuring Cardi B. Now, I think the album was initially 13 tracks, and then he added Cardi B's song on here. So he was pretty hyped about that on Instagram. He jumped in the pool. As you guys saw the skit where he jumped in the pool, he was happy about it. So far, though, I'm a little disappointed. That's all I'm just saying. Big paper, so I deal with big haters. Big paper, so I deal with big haters. Got it out there, every wall in my palace. Clips don't push to anybody speaking malice. Fashion icon, couple million for my stylist. It's not bad, but it's not good. I think I that's what I'm coming up with. So, with the first half, we still got a second half. It's not bad, but it's not good. I think that, again, it's one of those beats that there's nothing creative. It's a freestyle. It's a freestyle drill beat. I'm not, bro, fuck, I gotta be nice for it, bitch. I don't give a fuck about this bitch. She ain't paying my bills. Like, I'm just saying, like, yeah, she sounds like she bit Nicki a little bit here. It does sound a little like a little Nicki Minaj type song. But again, though, it's just a freestyle. I don't think it's a worse track. I just don't think it's a whatever track to me. It's a skip. It's what it is. It's just a whatever track. If I don't take a break off, you would never get a year. Praying on my downfall, you never get a prayer. All right, so as for that Kevin Samuels comment, that can't apply to Cardi B because she has more money than, you know, a lot of 1% men out there. So she's in the 1%, so you can't really get Kevin Samuels. It doesn't apply to her. Second of all, the track, man. Again, my thing is too. I don't like bringing Drake into the conversation, but I know we all call Drake a biter, a chameleon, whatever you guys want to call him. But this is a prime example of why it is to stay in your lane. Hey, And Chibino, welcome to the stream, bro. Thank you for the 10 gifted subs, man. I love you, dog. I got the gazimus, man. Always, man. So much support. I always say, man, it's like W's in the chat. Yeah, give me some W's in the chat for my boy Chibino, man. You know, he told me he was going to be here at 1. We were only on track 3, so I started as late as I could for him. But I always say this, man, like, it's hard to jump on other type of beats that's not in your lane. You know, this is definitely not Cardi B's lane, bro. Like this kind of like drill rap shit, like, this is not what she does. And I feel like you can kind of hear it right here. It just sounds so forced. It sounds so whatever. I'm kind of just really, you know, indifferent towards it. Thralazar, man, I got the designers, man, for the Twitch Prime, bro. Appreciate you, man. Happy 6 months. You're welcome to the Discord, man. You're going to be in there soon whenever I do a Twitch Prime or do a subscriber stream. But I gotta say, like, man, I just think that Drake does it crazy. Like, Drake can usually get on any of these beats and sound good. I don't know how he does it, but he still does it. You gotta experiment at times too, but sometimes it's just kind of just like, nah. You know, like, it's just, that was no. She should never do drill ever again. Hey, listen. I would say Young M.A. would have probably ate that shit. You know, she is a true MC, so she would have ate that shit. Track 4, We Going Crazy, featuring the Fila Negro, Her, and Migos. Shawty Low, freestyle. Hey, what you talking about? It's hello. DJ Khaled. Yeah, we are. Oh, that one thing, Nancy. Oh. Bum, 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 be bum, bum. You got that one thing, Nancy. Murder, murder, yeah, right. Long road, we don't want to. Yeah, yeah, we high. Can't have no lame lips. Damn. That's kind of gritty on her side. She said, I don't want no lame niggas up fucking on my side. Like, damn, you supposed to be the subtle girl. You know what I'm saying? Fila Negro, you bringing that Negro side out right now. Sheesh. Yeah, I don't mind this track, but I mean. But it's not standing out for me. I feel like, in my opinion, man, like, I don't want to be too. A lot of people say nowadays I'm a little bit too uptight and I critique a little too hard. Like, I'm not just enjoying the music, but I'm just genuinely not enjoying shit. Like, there's something that you can't force, you know, and when you genuinely like something, you know, you get a certain reaction out of yourself that you like. I mean, when you feeling some shit, you know, there's a reaction that happens in your body and the chemical balances that work within your brain and your serotonin. I don't know how the fuck the shit work, but it's a chemical reaction that goes on, and then the excitement comes in your face. Pause. But it's like you hear the track and it just does nothing for me. Like, this shit does nothing for me at all. Like, it, the way it's hit, I'm not feeling it. I don't feel the beat. I'm not feeling the, it just feels like DJ Khaled, I'm going to make this. I'm not going to let nobody listen to it. We're going to release it. You know what I'm saying? Like, no greater, now she wanna taste it. I had to level up, I was too patient. Back to the hood, we going back to the base. They said they hate you, but smile on your face. Thought through that shit back and I double it. Flooded my wrist, if you play, you get kinda lit. They say we crazy. I told them we very crazy. We the best music. At least he said a different guy. Very crazy. Not just crazy. Very crazy. I mean, her is talented. I'm not gonna literally shit on her. No pun intended, because, you know, she's on DJ Khaled's album. It is what it is, you know. Whatever. I Did It featuring Post Malone, Meg Thee Stallion, Lil Baby, and DaBaby. This is an interesting mix right here. I wonder how this is going to go. Stay down till I came up. I did it. Looking for a true type bitch, let me be it. I'm from the south, never had a handout. Before I let my people starve, I take it out your mouth. These bitches so quick to switch up. Hey, I must say, after hearing the beat, because I've listened to so much music and I listen to music daily, I know what's going to happen. DaBaby, not Lil Baby, DaBaby is going to eat this shit. Watch it. In your mouth more than your spit. Really encourage my haters to talk. Throwing that shade only keeping me lit. How we say ooh at the same time? Ooh. But you know, you get the 4-pack of the sliders and what's that shit? You know, go to White Castle, they give you the 4 sliders. She wanted the sliders. You know, that's what she. Hey, I step on my city. Chopsticks sound like a guitar in the air. Stop and take a picture when I'm jumping up a layer. I didn't run into a little baby verse too as well. What I am really upset, though, man, I got to say about Lil Baby is, why the fuck is he on DJ Khaled's album 3 times? Where the fuck was he at on Slime Language 2? That bitch was nowhere to be found on the deluxe. He was on one track on the goddamn on the regular. What was he on the Slime Language 2? Ain't you a slat? Like, where the fuck you was at? New contract, I ain't signing that hoe yet. I've been playing flash, I done got good with the shit. I tell the paparazzi to get my angle every time they take my photo. Another one. Can I ask everybody a question though? Can I ask everybody a question though? Cause did I miss it? Where the fuck was Post Malone at? That bitch said the hook? That was him? There's no way that was him. There's no way that was him. That's him? There's no way that's fucking Post Malone, bro. There's no way that it sounds like. You guys are smoking fucking rocks if you think that sounds like Post Malone. That sounds the most like him? What Post Malone do y'all listen to? Am I, bro, there's no way. Y'all, am I in Tsukuyomi right now? Am I in fucking Tsukuyomi? Is these niggas fucking with me? Is these niggas fucking with me? I'm tripping? I guess it's him, huh? Like I said, look, I know y'all motherfucking Gen Z's be smoking all. Y'all be doing edibles. Y'all then y'all hit the bong, two bong rips. You take the wax pen. You be sticking the vapes rubs up your nose when you do the Molly. I know y'all on some other shit, bro. Cause there ain't no way that could be the same nigga. There is no way. I ain't never heard that Post Malone ever. Ever. I've never heard that side of Post Malone ever. This nigga been auto-tuned the fuck up every time he's made a song. Every time he's made a song, he's been auto-tuned the fuck up. Gotta get your flight real quick, sneakers. I must be tripping, bro. Like, I must be fucking goddamn tripping. Like, dead ass Wow. Okay. Let's go to the next track. I gotta read the chat, because I still trip. I gotta go up and read the chat. I thought it was Chris Brown, too. I gotta make my mind up. I'm gon' grind, gon' shine, and sometimes it's sunny, but sometimes it don't shine. It don't shine. And life is a bitch, but sometimes it's alright. I let it go. If you say that you love me, that shit better show. Oh God. Don't try and play like I'm slow, cause you been around the block and I know this is show. Turn on. $250,000 every time I do a pickup. Fans got their arms in the air like a stick up. Turn on. Honestly, bro, it felt like they made that song in 5 minutes, and that was not Post Malone. Oh man. Between the last track being Chris Malone. And then having this track right here with 21 Savage and Justin Bieber, you know, basically making it in 5 minutes. I just think that there's just no energy in the track. Not energy, there's just no sauce in the track. The sauciest track we got so far was I Did It. You know, I felt like Meg Thee Stallion ate her verse. I felt like Lil Baby did his thing. The Baby ate his verse. You know, Chris Malone on the hook. I think that it was... I'm just saying. Post Breezy doing his thing. I can't tell you. I'm just not really feeling it. I'm not really feeling it. Like, and it sucks because it's a lot of. It's crazy how it's like when the Nets get together, right? And then they get busted. who the worst team in the NBA? Who the worst team in the NBA? I can't even get a joke right. I don't even know who the worst. Like, who the fuck's the worst team? The Timberwolves. Going against the Timberwolves. Like, it's like the Timberwolves bust they ass. That's exactly what's happening right here. We got all these big hitters. And the album is getting his ass busted. Track 7, Body in Motion. I feel like this track has potential. I mean, I might grow on me. I'm listening to it now. I might grow. Dark lemonade got me right around toxic. She give me neck like an ostrich and a lobster. She like I stack. All right. Roddy Rich, give me head. Like an ostrich and a lobster. Body in motion.